and how many dads of three daughters tells their daughter, you're going to go to law school from age 9. That seed was planted firmly back then. And he was determined that even though he raised three girls, that we were going to be strong, independent, and self-sufficient women. One of the things that he told me, he told my sisters, was that don't settle for being the secretary. You're good enough to be the boss, and that's where I expect you to be. So when you're raised with that attitude, then you can accomplish that. And I think so many of our young girls are raised to be pretty, to be cute, to look nice, but are they really raised to use all of their talents, to really reach their potential? I went to a minority women's conference in 1989 and then met two other Asian women attorneys. And we hit it off. And we decided that we had so much fun just sharing stories, because, you know, sometimes things happen to you and you think, am I crazy? Am I the only one experiencing this? And so it helped to have someone else to share those experiences with, someone else to sort of boost you up when you're having one of those days where you just think, I'm never going to break through. And so that was the motivation behind founding the Asian Bar, because we figured there were other attorneys who felt like us. And that was the whole thing back in 1990. I think for the most part, women still have the trouble of being taken seriously. A lot of times the assumption might be, well, you're here just because we're supposed to be more diverse, so we're letting you in. But not necessarily that you're in because of your own merits. I think that still is the case to a great extent. I think people sort of assume that if you have a strange sounding last name, you don't have command of the English language. I remember so many times when I was asked, oh, when did you come into this country? And I said, well, four generations ago, you know, my great grandparents came here. That's just not what I think fits everyone's stereotype when they see a face like mine. You know, we're all blessed with special gifts and talents. And one of our jobs, I think, in our existence here is to try to figure out what they are and how to best use them.